Good morning. Thank you for joining us from the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Up in space, there's a new spacecraft in orbit today following its launch yesterday from the Ariane Space Launch Site in Kourou, French Guiana at 4:52 p.m. Central Time. The European Space Agency's Albert Einstein Automated Transfer Vehicle cargo ship is traveling along in a passive state today, making its way to the space station. The first of its engine firings to fine-tune its path to the space station is scheduled for Monday. The long journey to reach the space station will conclude with a scheduled docking to the aft port of the Zvezda service module on Saturday, June 15th at 8:46 a.m. Central Time. On the space station, the Expedition 36 crew is hard at work in their orbital laboratory. On board, the crew of NASA astronauts Karen Nyberg and Chris Cassidy, as well as European Space Agency astronaut Luca Parmitano, and Russian cosmonauts Alexander Mazurkin, Fyodor Yurchikhin, and Pavel Vinogradov, serving as commander, are in the afternoon of their crew day. In progress now is continued work with the ocular health study, which will collect data about the health and condition of various crew members' eyes and vision. That is the start of a new study which hopes to help identify and determine countermeasures for vision issues that have been identified with long-duration spaceflight. Both astronauts Karen Nyberg and Luca Parmitano are the test subjects for that study, which started this week, and have several hours dedicated to the various science runs associated with that experiment. They'll be assisted by Chris Cassidy for some of that work, including ultrasound scans of the eye as well as cardiac data collections, which are both planned for today. The afternoon also includes work with the Pro-K ongoing nutrition experiment, which Luca Parmitano and Nyberg are both participating in. That involves a strict diet regimen as well as urine and blood sample collections to help understand the nutritional requirements for long-duration spaceflight. Nyberg's also working on the total organic carbon analyzer water sample analysis today. Meanwhile, her fellow astronaut Chris Cassidy, again assisting her and Luca with the ultrasound eye scans. He'll also be working on the deployment of radiation monitor devices throughout the space station. Fellow European Space Agency astronaut Luca Parmitano, again participating in that Pro-K experiment, as well as Karen, and will be collecting data samples for that and has a familiarization time on his schedule for the afternoon. Their Russian cosmonaut counterparts will be working in the Russian segment. They also have a mix of maintenance and science activities, including some research with the Russian Kristall experiment. They'll also be performing the charging of the Iridium phones on board, stowage for the Progress cargo craft, as well as, again, more radiation measurement devices being collected and deployed throughout the Russian segment, and maintenance on the electric food warmer. Russian cosmonauts also had an audit of the lighting and power supplies in the Russian segment, as well as the inventory management system review, and also a number of hours set aside for review of the spacewalk timeline for the Russian spacewalk, which is planned later this month.